the middle of the road.
Hello, my name is Jackson Wood from Brooklyn, New York, and Oaktown House in South Wilford. I just, in the process of finishing development called Pointer Woods, and I want to tell you all that I've been here since I was a little kid. My father came here since I was a little kid. And we always enjoyed the summers in the Catskills. The traffic that we have on weekends, like Rivki mentioned, it's always been an issue on 2 weekends out of the year. Primarily, we have camps here. And all I remember from memories from my childhood is that we had little bungalow shacks and it looked disgusting when you passed by. We're here to bring them to beautify the town, to bring winterized homes, although it's primarily occupied only 2 months out of the year. And I must say that the town of Fallsburg does a very, very thorough research and prior to giving us approvals. As a matter of fact, I myself, before getting approvals on my place, I had to pay $350,000 to upgrade the sewer. And that's going to fix the problem. By us paying the money, it's not the locals who pay the money. I was pleading with the water and sewer department, instead of forking out $350,000 all up front, I said, split it with me. I'll give you half now, when you give me the permits, when we wrap up the development, before we close, we'll give you the other 50%. They said, no, we need the money now in order to implement to upgrade the facility. So my money is out of my pocket. It's actually the town of Fallsburg. What they did with it, I have no clue. I'm assuming they're putting it to good use. That's number one. Number two, we spend, to answer the question about modulars, yes, we have modular homes here. Out of a $16 million project, $9 million went to the locals. That includes carpenters, lumberyards, plumbers. And like $16 million over here in the town of Fallsburg. And that's supporting the entire community. And by having a moratorium, that's not fixing the problem. Fixing the problem is putting your money where your mouth is, spending the money, giving it to the town. That's what I've done. That's what your Ellen Brazel have done. We do, as far as the traffic, we have to do traffic studies. We spend hundreds of thousands of dollars on all these things. And it's not that we're not paying, we want to beautify the town as well. We're not here to take advantage, and primarily, like I said before, it's only occupied primarily 2 months out of the year, and that summer traffic we always have. Why don't I hear any screams about the casinos? They're here, they're coming up here, and they're going to be spending money to the casino, but not to the town, not to the taxes. I took a piece of land that I paid $20,000 in taxes. And now we're imposed $4,000 in each home, multiply that by 70, that's $280 additional $1,000 that's going to the town out of the state of tax. That's the price. Now, coming to the question about the 6-pound pool, putting it through a 3-pound pail, let me tell you something. I spent $25,000 on a grinder that takes a 6-pound pool and grinds the liquid and puts it into a 3-pound